In this screencast, I'm going to show you how to make a pretty sophisticated user form in VBA. It's going to allow the user to select a three-dimensional shape, and then the user form is going to calculate either the surface area or the volume depending upon what the user desires. So we're going to have four different shapes that we're going to work with. We have a rectangular prism. We're going to have just a simple cone. Pyramid with a non-necessarily square base, so we can have A and B as the base, but this is a right pyramid with height h. Or we can have a spheroid, so it's basically a sphere that's been stretched or compressed. Now, the first thing whenever you're making a user form is to sketch out what you want the user form to actually do. Don't just go straight into VBA and start making your user form. You're going to get very confused. It's good to sort of outline, make kind of a flow chart. So I've kind of sketched out what we want this user form to do, and we're going to have a main form, and we want it to be able to allow the user to select between four different options: the rectangular prism, the cone, pyramid, spheroid, and then we're going to have a go button on the left and a quit button if we're done doing calculations. When we press go, we want, if rectangular prism is selected, we want another user form to pop up. And ideally, we'd like that first main form to sort of hide for a few moments while we're making the selections and inputting stuff into the second user form. So we've got inputs for A and B and C, which are the three lengths of this rectangular prism, and the user can either select area or volume. So for example, if the user put in 2, 3, and 4 and press go, then ideally another output box would come up and say the area is whatever, and that's the surface area of this prism. And obviously we need to find the formulas for all the surface areas of those objects and the volumes of those objects. Now, the best thing to do when creating a user form is to start out not with a user form, but to start out with a module, and this is kind of our base module. So here we have a central module I'm going to name Shape Solver. So Shape Solver is the actual module. It's a sub in VBA that we run, and when we run that, it's going to actually open up our user form. So we're not actually running the user form. We are running a module that will open up the user form. And in this example, we might have some code at the beginning that actually enables that main form user form to open. So when we run the Shape Solver sub, it's going to actually open up our first user form. Now, when we talk about how to code this main form, we're going to actually make it so that when they click on the Go button, it's going to do something. When you click Go, this isn't what comes up when the user form is run. This is the VBA code that's behind this Go button. And I'll show you this in a few moments, but For here, usually when you click on a button, it'll give you a private sub. So this is called private sub go button. And in this go button, we're going to have code. And we have four different options. The first one is if the user selected that rectangular prism radio button. If they did that, we're going to have some code in here. So we're going to have some if-then statements. If they selected that radio button corresponding to the rectangular prism, then we're going to have some code in here. We're going to open up that rectangular prism form, and we want it so that the user can input A, B, and C, select either area or volume, and then press go. And when they press go, initially want to hide this form, and then once we've hidden that form, when you hide a form in VBA, it actually goes back to where you called or opened that user form up. Once the code has done the calculations, it's going to export that in an output box. In addition to the rectangular prism, we're actually going to have three others. So let's take a look first at how we can actually build this main form user form. And we can open up the editor by doing Alt F11. Here I have a module, but I can also insert a user form. So let's start out with this module. I'm going to create a sub. And again, it's good practice to just kind of have a central module that sort of controls everything. So now I'm going to insert a user form. It provides this construction frame where and toolbox where we can input text, we can input a text box, we can input radio buttons. To get this thing started, I'm actually going to insert a picture and format different things. So here I have a picture. Next, I'm going to input something called a frame. And a frame is good to use when you have radio buttons. It allows you to have multiple choices within that frame. So it makes it so if you select another option, it deselects the previous selected option. Other things we can do, I can change the caption. So I'm actually going to change this to 3D Jape Solver in 1.0, and you can name these things however you want. I can click in the frame and get rid of that caption. So here we have captions. I'm just going to delete that. Now I'm going to go back and input some radio buttons. So I'm going to name this Rectangular Prism. I can also add the Go button. I can select down here for font size. I'm going to name that button Go button. Okay, I can copy buttons. You can paste them. Just make sure you label it something else, and this will be like our quit button. So I'm done. I'm going to rename that quit button. This is how we go about adding things to our user form. So I finished making the main form, and now what I've actually done is I've created four more user forms, and they correspond to rectangular prism, cone, pyramid, and spheroid. So for example, the cone form looks something like this. Again, I have my Go button. I haven't done anything with that yet, but I've named that Go button here. I also have input cells. So this is actually, if you go up here to the text box, I've named that cone H input for height. And you can set defaults in here by going to the bottom here on the left, and you can change the text here. So if I wanted 3, it's sort of nice to have defaults in there. I've also added a frame here with two options for radio buttons. I have surface area, and I've named these cone surface area and cone volume. I've added a nice picture there and labels for R and H. So I've done this for the cone, the pyramid, the prism, and the spheroid. Now we need to actually do something with the user forms and connect them to each other and connect them back to our original sub. So if you recall, our original sub was a shape solver. Remember, we're going to actually run the sub and not the actual main form. When we run the sub, we just want to add a simple code here that says mainform.show. So main form, remember, is the name. If I go back to my main form, I've named it main form. So when I write mainform.show, that's going to actually show the main form. So I'm just going to press F8 right now to step through this. And we see that what happens is in Excel, it brings up our main form. So we've opened up the main user form, which is here. And now to actually make it do calculations, depending upon what the user selects of these four, we need to have some if-then statements. So I'm going to double click on this Go. This is where we're going to put most of the code. And then I'll show you in a moment what I'm going to do with the quit button. So I'm going to double click here. It opens up and makes this new private sub called Go button click. So when you click on that Go button, this is what's going to happen. I'm just going to create a variable pi. Remember that there is no pi in VBA. And then the other variable we're going with is e. So pi here is going to be equal to 4 times the arctangent of 1. And now here's where I'm going to put the different selection criteria. So I'm starting with the rectangular form. If main form, that's the object, recall that I named this rectangular prism radio button, I named it rectangular prism. If main form dot rectangular prism, and that's all you have to do, because remember, rectangular prism is a Boolean, it's either true or false. If that's selected by the user, then I want to show the rectangular prism form. Rectangular prism form has different things. Okay, first of all, if we select surface area, that's going to be rect surface area here, and then we have rect volume, and then we bring in different things, but different variables. This is rect A input, we have rect B input, and rect C input, and we want to connect everything together. So we're going to show the rectangular prism form, and then I'm creating a variable here, surface area output, and now this is where I'm defining the formula for surface area. I've already created a surface area form, and that looks something like this. This box here is a label, so you can actually create labels where the code determines what's going to go in that label. And I've just made the back color of this white. And this label is called output, and it's in the object surface area output. So back in our code, surface area output, that's going to be the output in that surface area box, equals now the formula for output. So I've put in all the formulas for surface area and volume. For example, if they select the rectangular prism here, I've got formulas for the surface area and volume depending upon what they chose in that second radial button on the rectangular prism form. After I define the surface area, I'm going to show that surface area output form, and again that looks something like this. And one thing I need to do is create a button here that closes this form. So if I double click on this button, all we want to do is hide that user form. So let's go back to our main code. I've done the same thing with a volume output form. Now instead of just having the rectangular prism code, I also have code for if they select the cone, pyramid, and the spheroid. For each of these four different scenarios where we have the four different radio buttons, in the code I have to show each of those forms. So if they choose rectangular prism, the first thing we have to do is actually show the rectangular prism form. Same thing with cone, we have cone form show, and so on. You'll also notice that when I'm referring to different variables like R or I or H or A or B, I can't just write rect A input. I have to do rect prism form dot rect A input, and that corresponds to A that was input in rectangular prism form. Now, the last thing we want to do is on the main form, when they're completely done, you don't just want this form to just linger there. You want to somehow have a way to shut this down. And so if we double click on this quit button, and what we want to do is unload main form. Unload essentially clears everything and shuts it down. All right, so let's go back to the main Excel sheet, and I'm going to insert a picture. And this picture is going to be just my shape solver logo, and I'm going to assign the shape solver macro. So now everything's good to go. I'll press this, it opens up my user form. Let's do cone, go. By default, I have 2 and 4 in there. If I wanted, I could change it to 3 and 4. Say I want the volume, and I can press go, and it spits out the volume in my output box. And then let's just make sure that the last thing is working here. I'm done. We click that and it shuts it down. And we can always run it again by restarting. So that's the basics of creating a rather complex user form that has multiple options. The complete file for ShapeSolver can actually be found on learnchemy.com, and then go to Screencast Engineering Calculations. It might look a little bit different than this, but down here you can find complete user forms in VBA, and here's the actual code file.